What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today we're going to check out a WordPress plugin that's called LinkWhisper. This one is an internal link builder, plus it's going to help you with your Google ranking. The way it works is that it finds other posts that have to do with the post you're reading already, and you'll find links inside of those paragraphs that have to do with something that you're reading already. Let's take, for example, Wikipedia, which is really famous for doing this. If you're reading about World War I, well, you're going to find a lot of people who are involved, countries, and dates, and all of that. Well, when you read that, you're going to find links inside of there. Those are internal links. So if you're reading about World War I, they're probably going to mention World War II. And if you see that, well, there's going to be a link that's going to take you to more information about World War II. And that's how Internal Link Builder works. So people stay inside of your domain. And apart from that, LinkWhisper does a couple of other things, which I will be showing you on this video. So let's go jump over to my dashboard right now. Okay, everyone, this is the LinkWhisper site, and there's a deal that's going on right now. That link will be in the description. So if you plan to buy this, do head on over there and check out that link. Okay, so let me head on over to really quickly show you Wikipedia, because I mean, they're really famous for this. I just opened up Wikipedia, and obviously we are talking about Wikipedia, and you'll find information about it, and you'll find a lot of internal links that are highlighted right here. So anything that has to do with someone that's special, well, there's a link there. Let's just say J. Thomas. So if I go to J. Thomas, it'll take me to another Wikipedia that has to do with J. Thomas, and inside of there, there's other links that are internal reference. All right, so basically that's the most important part about LinkWhisper. Now let me go to one of my sites to show you what the LinkWhisper dashboard looks like. And I already scanned my site, and you're going to see the link stats. This is the main dashboard. We're gonna see posts crawled, links found, internal links, orphan posts, which don't have any links that cross-reference through each other, broken links, which is something really important that you should be looking out for. There's a bunch of them that I need to fix, and 404 errors, okay? And then we're going to see the most linked to domains. In this case, I use this site for affiliate links, so you'll find a lot of links that have to do with AppSumo, all right? And we'll see the internal versus external links, just a really quick pie chart that you're going to look at there. Okay, before we jump into this, I want to really emphasize that you start off with settings. Let's go into settings, because your site might not be in English. You might have a site with another language, so please start here. First of all, we're going to be asked for LinkWhisper, create internal links, open in a new tab. So for internal links, I would say I would keep it off, but it's up to you if you want to open them in a second tab. And for created external links, I do want them to open in a second tab, all right? So it's up to you how you set this up. We can ignore numbers, the selected language. These are the languages that are available as of this video. They will be adding more. And if your language is not there, well, ask them for them, see if they added, okay? It's really important that you select the language that your site is on, because it has to do with the SEO and how it finds more posts. Plus, it's gonna update the ignored words, okay? So right here, you're going to see the ignored words are right here in English. And if I select another language, it's going to update it. Example, here's a Spanish site that I have. I selected Spanish, and it's going to ignore these words as keywords. Why? Because obviously they're going to be filler words like a, about, above. So you use these words really commonly. So you don't want LinkWhisper to use these. Now, if you know that you have more words to ignore, well, add them here. And over here, we have the post type to create links for. Do you want to create for post? I would suggest yes, obviously. And maybe turn off for pages. So you don't want to do internal links for internal pages, for pages, right? Just for post. And if you have different type of tags right here, you can add them also. Different type of posts, right? You might have some custom, all right? Terms type to create links for. If you want to create links for categories, post tags, nav, menu, and you can keep those off. And also, if you want to do internal links for also private posts, future, and pending and draft. These are off, but let's just say that you work a lot with pending posts. Maybe you want to turn this on, because first, you have a virtual assistant that makes posts and then you check them out, but you want to take advantage of this feature and start working with internal links. Number of sentences to skip. This is also really important. For example, if it's going to do internal links, maybe you don't want to saturate it too much. So if there's three paragraphs, well, let's just say there's five paragraphs. There's going to put one in the beginning, one in the third, and it's just gonna skip because there's no sixth, right? If it finds two of those internal links that you want to link to, you can set it to 0 or up to 10 because maybe you don't want to saturate it too much. We can max outbound links per post. So let's just say, hey, you know what? Just it's 1. Don't get crazy. Or maybe 2 or 3, depending how you want to set this up, right? Up to 100. Max inbound links per post and add a destination post title to links. This is really important that you set up for to get started, right? Because once you do this, then you go scan your site. If not, you'll scan your site first, use the settings, and then go scan again, all right? You can ignore content, and there's also advanced settings, all right? Let's go back to our dashboard. Okay, like I mentioned before, here's the dashboard. Here's the total post crawled, 1,271, but we're gonna head on over to orphan post. Why? Because this is where we want to get started. There's nothing going on, so there's no internal links, there's nothing connecting to it. The only way that Google is going to rank this is if it crawls the sitemap, all right? But if not, what happens if we have other sites, other pages, well, not pages, other posts that are ranking and have a cross-reference to that link? Well, it's gonna strengthen that, okay? So let's get started here. Let's add some links for this right here. Now, remember we talked about the pages. We don't want internal links for GDPR privacy policy, just an example. Okay, let's select this one. Let's wait for it to scan. It's gonna find other posts that have to do with this. Well, this is actually a pretty bad post to actually get started with. Let me find something more relevant. Software licensing for, okay, this one's a good one. Let's start with that one. Now, I would really recommend LinkWhisper for blogs. In this case, I'm only using this for affiliate posts, but since I'm going to use LinkWhisper here, the best thing I could do is use it as a blog. For example, I can make a cross-reference internal link for anything that has to do with lifetime or yearly, have it to go to another post that has to do with lifetime. Maybe I can make a post explaining what a lifetime, what lifetime is in this kind of niche. And every time that lifetime is mentioned, I can make them go to that post. So people cross-reference inside of the same domain. I think I get kind of through of this, all right? Okay, here it is. We have settings like this, only show link suggestions in the same category. So let's just say that you have several categories and you don't want to do internal links for different type of categories. If they differ a lot, let's just say that you're talking about dogs and that category is about dogs, but you also have other categories in your blog about cars, right? You don't want to do internal linking for those two. So maybe you want to keep it tight inside of the same category. It's just an example that I'm giving you there. Only show link suggestions with the same tag as this post. Again, same situation would go that way. Filter displayed posts by published date. So maybe you want to do it from a certain date range for the newer post, older post, or just whatever date range that you want to choose. And on the bottom, we get the suggestions. This is the page, all right? And we are looking for other posts on the same site to link to this one, all right? That's the idea of this. So it found this post right here, Blitz Payment Plugin for WordPress. And it's saying this is the paragraph that it found and what it suggested. So this, if I enable this and I add the link, it's gonna link to here, right? So I can check this on. There's another one available. Let me find this. Okay, this one has several ones. This one found several paragraphs that you might want to link to, right? So let's open this. This has 3 suggestions, all right? So every time it found WordPress plugin, it'll jump over there. Like I said, this is not a blog site, so this might not be the best thing to do. For example, if it talks about WordPress, we don't want it to go to this link. But if this was a blog post and we're talking about WordPress plugins and all of that, we might have a main blog post that has to do with actual WordPress, and we'll jump them to there. We can select what part of the sentence we want them to jump over there. And we can also edit the sentence. So for example, if I edit this sentence, I can actually update the whole sentence because I want to make it a little bit more reference to what it has to do with this main site. But if not, I could change where I want to link. So for example, I can remove this link. For example, edit, I can grab this link. Let's unlink it. and we might want to link it here. All right, we'll put back the link. And if I update this, I save it and I add the link, it's gonna add it there, okay? So I can edit it right from here without having to actually go to the post. So that's really interesting that we could do that. And all you have to do is actually check these off, the ones that you want to work with, and you can add the link. It'll do this automatically on those posts. You don't have to do anything else. And once you go check them out, you'll see that the link is over there. So you saw how easy that was to create internal links using LinkWhisper. If we didn't have this, it would be super time consuming and you wouldn't even want to do it. But having this plugin saves you a lot of time. Now, link reports, that's what we saw at the beginning. This is the whole links, and we'll see the title, inbound links, the outbound internal links, and the outbound external links. So we see that these posts have outbound external links. You see how many they have. We can actually view the links that it's going to. All right, you have that options available there. We have the domain report. This is where we're going to see a list of domains that are being used on this website that are going outbound. So this is the main domain that's been using. Like I said before, I'm using this for AppSumo. So you'll see the amount of posts that have that link and the amount of links. So obviously there's this amount of posts with all these links on there. There's the click reports. In this side, it hasn't had a lot of time with this plugin installed, but I think there should be some link clicks here. Let's go there. Okay, so this one is the one that's been having more clicks. Let's click on it. You'll see total link clicks, clicks over the past 30 days, most click links, so load more, and view detailed clicks report. We can view that there. Let's actually check that out. I haven't seen it for myself. Okay, so there's a chart here with all the information, where it's going to. All right, let's go back. And we also have the error report. Again, you'll have to scan the site for the first time, which is gonna scan for broken links. This is super useful because, like you can see right here, there's a lot of links that are broken. Imagine this site, okay, that has affiliate links and they're broken. Well, I gotta go fix them because if someone clicks on it, well, it's not gonna work. It's gonna take them to a 404 page, which I don't really want to. Plus, Google is probably not gonna like that, so it's gonna reduce my ranking because I have a lot of broken links. So I gotta dedicate some time, not right now, but I will dedicate some time to fix those links, to either fix them or remove that blog post that it's not really even relevant anymore. So that's something I have to do. All right, so other things that I like right here is the auto linking. This feature is pretty cool. This one will create some automation for you. What it's going to do is, for example, for every keyword that it finds with whatever keyword you put right here, it's gonna take them to a certain link. Take for example here, I put this keyword. If AppSumo is mentioned, then I wanted to add the affiliate link, and it's already added it to 582 posts. Now imagine doing that manually, that's time consuming. Like I said before, you even wouldn't want to do it because, hell, that's a lot of time. So let me show you what other use cases could be right here. Let's just say you're talking about, let's just say cows, all right? So if the word is mentioned cows, then I want to take them to a post that has to do with specifically with cows. I don't know, cow milk or a product that you're selling for cows, and you'll just put the link there, okay? This is really important that you click on the gear button because it'll give you extra options that are really useful. For example, add links if post already has this link. So I wouldn't add that. If it's already added, don't add it. So I'll keep it off. Only link once per post. So don't go crazy if cows are mentioned 20 times. No, only link it once. Select links before inserting. So I'll do this manually to select them before. Set priority for auto link insertion. This is really important also. So let's just say I have, I don't know, three automations that are kind of similar. Let's just say we have AppSumo, we have Lifetime or other keywords, all right? We can set which one we're going to give it priority. So if it finds the three, it'll put the first priority that you set. Only add links to posts published after the given date. So important if you only want to post newer posts, all right? And restrict auto linking to specific categories. So if you don't want to auto link to some type of category, maybe, I don't know, that doesn't have to do with anything related to your site. In this case, well, whatever, let's just say dogs again. If you don't want to add those auto links to the dogs category, well, you set it there. If not, keep it off. and you save it. And it's gonna automatically add it to past post plus future post. You don't have to do this every single time. So if I write a new blog post and AppSumo was mentioned, it's gonna automatically add it there. I don't have to do anything additionally. So it helps me with that. There's also the target keywords. We can also set target keywords, which is going to search keywords that are used in your blog post. Remember, when you write a blog post, you have your title, your description, well, the content, and on the right, you have your image, and you can also add keywords. Those keywords are right here, and we can work with those keywords also. So we can view these, we can edit, we can add inbound links, we can see the date published, the active keyword, organic traffic. Again, there's not a lot of information right now because I just added this plugin recently, so you won't see a lot of information there. The SEO press keywords, in my case, that's what I'm using. If you're using Yoast, RankMath, and all of that, it'll work with that also, and it'll find them here. And custom keywords. So basically, that is LinkWhisper. It has a lot of things that you can do with it, but the most important part of all is the internal link building. What I like about it is the internal link building, which is super easy to use because it's gonna find other posts that are relevant and you can link to them. The other thing that I like is finding the broken links. And the third thing that I like is the auto linking, which saves me a lot of time because I will be finding specific words that I find that should be auto linked to another blog post that I have. Plus, it's gonna help me get content in here. So I will be creating content that has to do with what I'm doing right now. So if I'm talking about lifetime, well, I wanna make a blog post that talks about lifetime so people understand what it's for, what it does, how it works, and all of that. So every time the word mentioned lifetime, well, I'm gonna take them to there so they can read about it. So that's just an example of what I'm going to do in the future. Well, there you go, guys. If you guys want to grab LinkWhisper, there will be a link in the description. I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.